be. Sorry. fertilizer. They added stomach noises, interesting. Drop you guys. knowledge first. Okay, so we do a workshop, food storage. How does it? I'm confused. Well, that makes sense there too. So I only picked up 10. Okay. Thank you. Well, this is different. You should be able to make it easier. Smithy to get to the tools now. Damn, that's gonna be annoying. Alright. We'll have so much. Super slow. Alright, drop two of you. Quickly. Help the poor guy. Got him where they kill him. Might have to get tanked by another four. Both. Alright. Okay. I mean, this cart looks like it's in good condition. Can I have it? Hunting a deer right now. I have no idea what that noise was. Guessing it was that cat. Cat. So, skills. Let's take a look at our skills. Is it this one? No. You. What is that? Oh my god, it tells me stick snap. So weird. I guess everybody was complaining about the difficulty of finding. Stones. I just walked into a pig. I really did. One of those spears. Is that a moose? Right in the middle of the danger zone, it speaks in spears. looks a lot like a moose. Like a baby moose. How you doing, Demko? Why do the reeds look like they're having a seizure? Good. They made me an affiliate today. Twitch did. Third playthrough, but my first one was a year ago when it went into early access. Sorry, is that any better? My first playthrough of this game was literally a year ago when it came into early access. I bought it the day it came out, and then it was released in full last week, but I haven't played it yet. So this is my third playthrough of it, and they've added a lot. I mean, I played it a few months ago, and they had added bobcats, or lynx, whatever we want to call them. Now I think I just saw a baby moose. Oh, you're a wolf. Crap. Out of spears.
That is the first time I've ever died in the game. What is the goal of the game? This game is a first-person city builder. So, I was just collecting reeds for my first house. So, you basically... It's a medieval... it's a medieval city builder that you basically, you start, you come into this land to find your uncle. Your parents were just killed in a war, so you're trying to, like, basically start over. But your uncle, when you get here, you're told your uncle's dead. So... The Castilian here, who is your uncle's friend, gives you, basically he allows you to build wherever you want for free. However, you have to pay taxes on everything that you build. And you recruit people who will work for you, they will make families and all of that. And you have to basically... You have to basically feed everybody, give them fuel for their house, and tools to work. Last time I played, they didn't have clothing for, like, you didn't have to clothe your people. It would be amazing if they added that in. In my last playthrough, I'm building in the same place I did in my last playthrough. You basically, well, that's different. You don't babysit them. The stuff just has to be in storage, so you just have to have stuff in the storage here. You can only, like, you can, basically, to recruit people, the more people you recruit, the higher your dynasty reputation has to be. And what I didn't realize in the last time, so if you put a man and a husband, or a man and a woman in the same house, they will basically start a family. And have kids, and then when the woman has a child, she won't work until the child is two. What I didn't realize is that whenever you have a child, whenever a child is born in your village, the amount of dynasty reputation required for you to continue recruiting also goes up. So I was at like 16,000 dynasty reputation, and I had... Like, because I had 16 children in my village. I had, yeah. So I was just getting, like, I couldn't recruit people without doing a bunch of missions that I don't care really to do. Yeah, they basically just take what they need. They don't even go to the storage for the most part. They just basically, it gets deducted. Now, does this not look like a baby moose to you? That still looks like a baby moose with antlers. What I'm thinking is I'm just going to recruit males to start. I mean, I've come face to face with moose. They're bigger than me and I'm 6'3". So there's no way that I would say this is a full grown moose, but yeah. So I'm just going to recruit males for the first few years. To do a lot of the work. As they're working, their skill level does go up. So I don't know if I can show you without anything here. Management. No, because I don't count. Maybe when I built it, when it, maybe, sorry, maybe when I built the house. Where are you from? There's another one. These guys here will one shot you or two shot you. They're called bison, basically North American buffalo, bison, whatever we want to call them. And they're just aggressive as they are in real life. Washington State, born and raised, and still live. Yeah. I'm from Ontario, Canada. Okay, so. So every season in the game is 3 days long. The seasons are short. Now, a lot of people, when the game first came out, people complained about it. So they did make it, you allow. So here's the house. Here's my first house, it's the smallest. Okay, so. I have an arrow. Oh yeah, I found a storage. Or I found a cart that had overturned and it had a bunch of stuff in it. Everything in here right now. What did I just pick up? Arrows. Okay, so we're done. So I planted some cabbages quickly. I built this first because it used to be. This is the workshop. You used to need the workshop to make shovels, but you can't now. I didn't know that. You now need a smithy to make shovels. And you need a shovel to get rid of stumps. So I'm building in the middle of a forest. My house usually goes here. Beside this little brook, and on this beautiful lake, the mountain behind it. This game is beautiful. Winter in this game is absolutely stunning. So I will be doing a lot of deforestation through this. Trees do grow back if you leave them alone. But I need this area. On this side I won't cut down much. Basically, you're gonna stretch it out along this lake. So I wanna get the next crops planted. I need flax planted quickly. I have 15. Let's do it out here. Thank you. Turk really quickly. Basically, I spent most of the first day at the, like, in the starting area, just collecting a bunch of stuff to trade. So I bought seeds and fertilizer. And I'm gonna plant it all now for summer. I have cabbage, which you can plant in spring and summer, so it basically you plant it in spring, harvest it in summer, plant it in summer, harvest it in winter or autumn. But I'll need more fertilizer for that as well. Where was I just doing this? I just got myself lost. There it is. Fertilizer. So as you do things in the game, you get more technology. Basically, your technology is from your experience. There is no research or anything like that. As your technology goes up, you get more buildings, and then you get more things that you... any crafting recipes you have to buy. Okay, so we're gonna fertilizer. Oops. And we're planting flax. Gotta hoe it first. So the funny part though is like you'll have crops that take one season, and I can plant them tomorrow, and then the next day, because tomorrow's the last day of this season, the next day they'll be ready to harvest. Can I make another one? I need a log. So I have 15 seeds and 15 plot. One, two. Farming in the nighttime here in this game is major pain, but you can't see anything at all. I'm dirty. For a swim in the lake. If you get too dirty, you get sick. Also, if you're trying to talk to people and you're dirty, nobody will like you. Where am I going this way? Can I make a scythe? I'm gonna have to buy a scythe, I just realized that, okay. Clean. Later on we can make a bathtub. Alright. So there are three levels of houses. This is the smallest. Basically you have a husband, wife, and one child. The second one is two children, and the third one is three children. Okay, so we're just gonna cook on the fire all the meat that I just got. Oh, I hear my stomach going. See, this is what vintage story needs, is a stomach rumble before you start getting hurt. Right, man, I'm just gonna take a drink of water. And similar to Vintage Story, I basically use nighttime as crafting time. Just sit inside and craft. You can sleep through the night. You have to sleep through the third night, or the last night going into the next season. You don't go to bed, it just knocks you out, basically. Screen fades to black, and you wake up on your bed. Okay. Inventory. So, just took 12 meat for me to... be satisfied. Alright. Keep doing that. So, and our skills. We got farming skill, let's get more knowledge so we get more skill faster. So you have different trees here. You have one for extraction, which is farming, and or sorry, not farming, this is logging, mining, and that kind of stuff. One for hunting, which basically we'll want... is it tracker? Yeah. Tracker as soon as possible, because when you push a... I don't know if you... like, what was that game called? The Assassin game. Assassin's Creed, apparently you can see there's a button you can push and it shows you everything. This is the same, it shows you animals in red. But you have to get one of the first levels first. Farming. Diplomacy. This is fishing and something else. Oh, just survival. Oh, Yeah, survival, picking everything up off the ground. Yeah, and this is crafting. So in crafting, basically you have crafting, which is making tools, and that sewing, cooking, building. So yeah, if I push Alt, you can see all the things. Except when you get the hunting one, when you push it, animals will show up red. So we can collect these. Here's the map. It looks big. From where we are, okay, one second. Like, you can't go over here, so I think this is as far as you can go. So it's 1.5 kilometers. So it's about 2 kilometers, really. By 2 kilometers. They've added bandits into the game as well. I haven't seen them yet. There's 3 different kinds of trees to cut down. Spruce gives you 3 logs, maple gives you 4 logs, and birch gives you 2 logs. And there goes my torch. I'm gonna be playing in the dark for a minute. These bushes here give you berries in the summer. It's funny, you can collect the berries now, and at the beginning of the game, it gives you, like, a bunch of little tutorials pop up, and one of them says, "You don't eat unripe berries." So you can collect the berries now, but they're unripe. If you eat them when they're unripe, it poisons you, and there's people complaining that they kept dying from eating unripe berries. And it's like, it tells you not to eat them. Why don't you read the instructions? St. John's wort cures your poisonous, so if you eat something that poisoned you. Sorry, it's so dark. There's literally nothing you can do about it. I guess I could sleep. Now people don't listen. Where's the door? There's the door. Sleep? Oh, that's different. I don't know why you'd sleep till next season. So much to do. Alright, so I have that. And I have that. Now, where are we on the tech tree for... See, and this is for technology. We have... basically, this one is resources. So a resource storage woodshed gets you logs. If you have somebody working there, they'll get you logs, sticks, and lumber. That's the second house. This place gets you stone and salt and clay. That's more storage, more And there's the mine, which is a mine. And there's the third house. This one is for mostly hunting. That's a different building I haven't seen yet. Hunting, fishing, herbalism now. A well. That sounds interesting too. Sorry, there's actually quite a bit that they've changed. So I need a burn. Can I get a burn yet? I can. This is my favorite. This game came out last year and it's one of my favorite games. Like, it was definitely my favorite of last year. When they put it out, there was a lot to it. Since then, they put out a lot more to it. Okay. Let's make some knives and go to town. Are these gonna expire? I don't know if bread will rot or not. Sorry, let's drop a lot of this stuff because it weighs a ton. Oh, my storage is full. Damn it. Alright. Grab all the sticks and stones. Should have done this instead of sleeping. So I'll take it to one of the little tents by me. All these exclamation marks, they're quests people give you. Or somebody wants to talk to you. That's how you gain reputation points or dynasty points. Basically, you in the game, you want to get married and you want to have a kid so that if you die, you basically will respawn as your child. I have absolutely no idea what happens to your wife your wife mother at that point, because I was literally you when you came in. That was the first time I've ever died. I've actually been quite lucky. There's this stuff here. There's this stuff here. Lucky and cheaty. Yes. You just carry this with you. And at any point, when you click, go into this menu here, any of these menus here, you're paused. The game is paused. So if you're under attack, you can literally eat this and heal. It used to give you more. Now it only gives you two. So I'd be sitting there fighting wolves, and if I got hurt, basically I would just go in, eat that stuff, heal. What is that? What is that? Okay. I'm going the wrong way. Let's go here. Yeah, I think it's a lynx. Thank you. There's bears in the game. From the start, there have been rabbits. Rabbits, foxes, deer, boar, bison, wolves, bears. So this is actually one of the larger settlements in the game. And interesting, it has a palisade around it. Yes. The bears could kill you, the wolves could kill you, the bison could kill you, the foxes would attack you if you attack them first. You're one of my favorite people.
Be welcome!
Show me your wares. Want some knives? Oh, they're worthless here. Oh, no, they're not. That's my knife. Oh, knives decay now. Good. Okay, you can have two spears as well. This guy's one of my favorite because he gives you, or he sells you seeds. How much do we have? 230. So, okay. Do we want to get more crops? I didn't look at the crafting. Actually, let's look at it now.
See you soon!
K-T. Kitchen. Can I look at it? Doesn't let me look. Damn.